Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. Now, have you ever been to a Sephora abroad? Not in India, because we all know how many brands we get in India. It's hardly 8 or 10. But have you ever been to a Sephora abroad and ended up getting all confused and, you know, not knowing what to pick and what to avoid? Because Sephora stores are massive, they are huge, and they have thousands of products. So you might end up picking some wrong products. And of course, Sephora products are expensive as hell, so no one wants to waste their precious hard-earned money on something that they are not going to use. I remember my first time in Sephora, like when I entered a Sephora abroad, I was so overwhelmed, I was so confused, I didn't know what to pick, what to avoid. But over the years, I kind of gathered products that I started liking and that are kind of my all-time favorite products from Sephora. So in this video, I will discuss those products and let you know my thoughts, so that if you are on a trip, if you're planning a trip to a place where you have a Sephora outside India, you can give these products a try and pick them if you like. But in this video, I will not be focusing on the base products like foundations or concealers, because those products depend on your skin type, your skin preference, your skin tone, etc. So I will be talking about the colored products mainly. So let's get started. The first product that I want to talk about are these chrome paint shadow pots by Tarte. And these are basically pressed eyeshadows, and these come in like 6 or 8 colors, and they are so intense, so pigmented, and so easy to use, very, very creamy. And I basically love to use these with my fingers. I just apply it on my lid and, you know, just blend a little bit with a blending brush and I'm good to go. These require very little effort, but the output is really great and very beautiful. All the shadows have very high intensity and they are very, very pigmented. They go on your lids very smoothly, and in one swipe you get like full intensity. They stay on my lids for a very long period of time. They don't crease, there's no fallout. I mean, it's a great, great product, and they have some really beautiful colors. So the first shade is Fire Dancer, which is a beautiful burgundy maroon shade. The next shade is a beautiful duochrome shade, and it's called Froze. It's a pink with like a gold shift to it. Again, it's a beautiful, beautiful shade, great for summers. You can just slap it on your lids and you are out the door. You don't need a lot of effort for these eyeshadows. And then the next shade I have is Beach Bay. This is a golden bronze shade that is going to look absolutely stunning in weddings and parties, evening parties. It will go very well with our maroon or red based dresses. So yeah, these shadow paint pots, oh my god, sorry, these chrome paint shadow pots are absolutely gorgeous, and I think you should definitely give these a try. The next product that I want to talk about is again an eye product, and this is by Stila. This is their liquid eyeshadow. Now these come in two variants. This one is shimmer and glow, and they also have one that's called glitter and glow. Now I have 4 of these shades, and all of these shades are so beautiful. Again, these are very, very easy to apply. These come in like your concealer, kind of concealer pot, and they have this doe foot applicator. So you just apply your eyeshadow with the same applicator, let it dry for a while, and then yeah, you're good to go. So these again don't require a lot of effort. You can just either use the applicator that it comes with, or use your fingers, or use a synthetic brush to apply it all over your lid. Just wait for a couple of seconds or perhaps a minute, and once it dries down, you can just apply your mascara, falsies, whatever, and you're done. So these are again very, very beautiful. I have 4 of these shades. So Sunset Cove is a beautiful duochrome shade. It has pink with champagne glitter, I would say, and it also shifts towards green, turquoise, green. So it's a very, very, very pretty shade. Again, great for parties. If you just want to add some pop of color or some extra punch to your eyeshadow, you can use this shade. Then the next one I have is called La Douche, and it's a beautiful, beautiful olive color. This is in the Shimmer and Glow variant. Shimmer and Glow variants don't have glitter in them. They are just like your beautiful shimmer eyeshadows. And this again is a beautiful, gorgeous olive shade that is going to look stunning on brown skin tones. Then the next shade is Kitten Karma, and this is the Glitter and Glow variant. So it has a lot of glitter. This is your regular champagne color, but it looks absolutely gorgeous on the lids. Great for evening parties, our Indian parties or weddings. And then the last shade I have is Into the Blue. Now I'm not sure if Sunset Cove and Into the Blue are limited editions. I think they are, because I picked these up during the holidays, like last December. So I believe these two are limited editions, but Kitten Karma and La Douche are permanent products. But anyways, so Into the Blue is again a beautiful duochrome shade, and this has like a midnight blue and purple shift. I love all these eyeshadows. These are so easy to apply. They don't, even if you don't have any eye brushes, you can just use your fingers, and they are just effortless. Next, I want to talk about lipsticks. Now, I absolutely love these Bite Beauty Amuse Bouge lipsticks. These come in a creamy satin finish, and this is what the packaging looks like. These come in a variety of shades, ranging from nudes to reds to pinks to some deeper shades. So I'm sure you can find your perfect shade. I have this in, actually I have in 5 shades, but I think one of the shades is in my work bag and it's in other room. So I will be showing you these 4 lipsticks for now. Now these are made with food grade ingredients, so technically you can also eat them. And this is how the lipstick looks like. These are very, very intense, very creamy. When you apply, these just feel like butter. They give you full intensity in one swipe, and these smell like lemonade or I don't know, cola pop or something. These smell really amazing. They perform really well. They stay on your lips really well, and since they are not matte, they are not very, very long lasting, yet they stay on your lips for a really long time. And also when they fade, they leave like a really beautiful stain on your lips that doesn't look very bad, or there's no like white cast or anything. So these fade really beautifully. Even though they are cream, the lasting power is quite good. If you are in a Sephora that sells Bite Beauty, I highly recommend you to check this product. I absolutely love these lipsticks. Now let me go through the shades. The first one is Tannin, which is a beautiful deep red shade. Next shade is Beetroot. This is again a beautiful fuchsia, like a deep fuchsia raspberry shade. Again, beautiful for night outs, or even during the daytime you can pull it off really well. Then the next shade is called Pepper, and this is a mauvey, neutral, muted color. Then the next shade I have is Eggplant, which is a beautiful purpley shade. And I also have another shade that's called Chai. It's like a warm brown color that I keep in my office bag, and it's a beautiful, beautiful shade, apt for work. Now moving on to some face products, I have a bronzer by Becca, and it is called Becca Sunlit Bronzer. Now I have it in 2 shades, but of course you don't need to buy 2. Now these bronzers are beautiful. Like I have it in the shade Bronzed Bondi and Capri Coast. They have a little bit of shimmer to them, so when you apply it on your cheeks, it just gives a very, very nice luminous bronzy effect to your face. These are not very pigmented, which I like. So I can either build it up or I can make it very subtle. It totally depends on me. The formula is very, very soft, very creamy. It blends really beautifully. You just need a fluffy brush and just apply it wherever you usually apply your bronzer, and it's going to give you a beautiful bronzed look with a slight sheen. So I love the formula, I love the product. I highly recommend that you check these out. These come in like 5 or 6 shades, so I am pretty sure you can find your perfect shade. Even if you are not a fan of bronzer, you can just use these as your blush, like your neutral, warm blushes, and these will look really beautiful. The finish these products give is absolutely gorgeous. So great, great for summers. Now I know that Becca is available in Indian Sephoras, but I haven't really seen these bronzers in the store. So that is the reason why I included it in this video. Moving on to the next product, which is again a powder product, and this is slightly expensive, but it's totally worth the price in my opinion. And this is the Hourglass Ambient Lighting Powder. I have it in the shade Dim Light. Now the packaging is really beautiful. It looks really, really high class and very, you know, very chic, and it looks like you've spent a lot of money in getting this product. So when you open it, you get a mirror and then the product looks like this. And you can use this as your finishing powder. You can use this as your highlighter. I usually use it as my finishing powder, and this gives a very, very subtle glow to your face. It does not dry out your face at all. I have dry skin, so I prefer powders which don't dry out my skin or which don't look too cakey, and this is one of those powders that I absolutely love. It just gives a beautiful glow to my face. It has no shimmer, no glitter, nothing of that sort, just a very subtle luminous glow. Loving this Hourglass powder, and this is a staple in my work makeup bag when I'm going for work. This is something I set my face with, either this or the MAC Mineralized Skin Finish Natural. These are the two powders that I really love. Now the next product I have is a lip product, and this is by YSL. These are called the Glossy Stains, and I just have it in one shade because these are very, very expensive. But the product is absolutely gorgeous. I mean, this is again a staple in my work kit. This is something I put on when I don't want something very obvious on my lips. This is, I would say, it's a hybrid between a lipstick and a gloss. Stains your lips really beautifully like a lipstick, but it feels like a gloss, but without being very sticky or, you know, your hair all sticking out and looking all gross. No, it is a very thin formula. It stains your lips really well, like I said, and also the stain stays on your lips for a really long time. Even if you eat like a lighter meal, say a breakfast or a light lunch, it will survive your lighter meals. And the only thing that I don't like about this product is its smell. It smells like alcohol, but once it goes on your lips, you can't really smell it. So I mean, that is a negative point, but not really once it's on your lips, so it's okay. But these come again in a ton of shades, ranging from fuchsia to reds to neutrals. I have it in the shade, I'm sorry, the shade name has rubbed off, but I will try to find it and I will try to link it in the description box. But the shade is beautiful. It's like your neutral peachy brown shade. It looks really gorgeous on the lips. It looks very natural, and the staying power is great. The formula is great. It's very hydrating. It does not dry out your lips like some of the stains do. The application is also pretty easy. It comes in like this doe foot applicator style wand, so you can easily apply it on your lips. And this is something that I can be very sloppy with because it's a very neutral shade, so even if I don't have a mirror in front of me, I can just slap it on and I'm out the door. So yeah, check out these glossy stains and try to pick one. Of course, I really want to try out more shades, but these are very, very expensive, so I'm just stuck with one for now. But yeah, I am definitely going to pick more. The next product is again a powder product, and this is again by Becca. I love Becca's powder products. I love their highlighters. I love their bronzers. They are amazing. Now this one is technically a highlighter, but it's a little dark on my skin. Okay, the shade name is called Chocolate Geode. And I know Becca highlighters are available in India, but I'm not too sure if this shade is available yet. So this is like your bronzy chocolate color. Oh my god, the shade is absolutely beautiful. Look at the shade. So the reason why I love it so much is, even though I can't use it as a highlighter, I love to apply this as my bronzer. Like if I'm wearing a matte bronzer, I just go over it with this powder very, very slightly, because it's a highlighter. If I go very like full on, it is going to look a little too much. So I just take a little bit of this powder and apply it over my bronzer, and it just gives me a beautiful glow and I love it. Oh my god, the shade is absolutely beautiful. You can also use this on your eyelids, you can use this as your bronzer topper, you can also use this as your blush topper. If you are a little deeper than me, if you are somewhere around NC 45 50, I think this is going to look absolutely stunning. It's a gorgeous shade and I absolutely love it. So if you're someone who likes shimmery or glowy bronzers, I think you can give this a try. Just wear a matte bronzer and apply some of it on top of it, and it is going to look so beautiful, so glowy, and it is just going to make your summer even better. Now next I have a highlighter, which is again by Stila. Now I know Stila is available in Indian Sephoras, but I'm not sure if these Heaven's Hue highlighters are available or not. So I have it in the shade Kitten, but they have recently released it in a couple of more shades. Kitten is slightly towards the pinker side, but it still looks gorgeous. And this is what the packaging looks like. And when you open it, you have your mirror and then you have your highlight. Now this is the same highlighter that went viral as the putty highlighter, and people were like squishing it and playing with it and, you know, doing all sort of things. So it, when you swatch it, it feels really soft. The formula is really different and very, very soft, and there is no glitter or no shimmer in it. I absolutely love this highlighter. This is something that is going to give you just pure sheen, no glitter, no shimmer. You can tone it up or tone it down depending on your preference. If you just swipe it a couple of times on your cheekbones, it's going to build up and it's going to be really intense. But if you just swipe it very lightly, just once or twice, it's going to give you like that subtle glit from within glow. If you're a fan of non-shimmery, non-glittery highlighters, give this a try. You will not be disappointed. I have a couple of eyeshadow palettes. Now, if you go in a Sephora, the first thing that you will notice is eyeshadow palettes. I mean, eyeshadow palettes are everywhere. Every kiosk, every brand makes eyeshadow palettes. So you might get a little confused. And when you swatch it, I mean, in the store, under all those bright lights, every shadow looks beautiful. But when you come home and you try to blend it with your fingers or when you your brushes or whatever, then you realize that it's not a good formula. So I have four recommendations, and let's start with the first one. So the first one is Tarte Toasted Palette, and this is a warm eyeshadow palette. It comes with a big mirror, and then you have 12 shades. Now all the shades are warm. So if you like warmer shades, you can pick this up. These smell like cocoa powder. I love that smell. I feel like scraping it and eating it, but yeah, I should not be doing that. So you have a couple of shimmer shades, you have a couple of satin shades, some matte shades. Now the formula of these shadows is really good. You can blend the shadows easily. These are pigmented. And you can mix all the shades, they don't oxidize or anything, so easy to blend. So yeah, I think overall it's a good palette. If you want to invest in something that you can use regularly, I think this is a good one. And you can give this a try. If you're a fan of warm tone shadows, this is going to be a really good one for you. Now the next eyeshadow palette I have is from Too Faced, and it's their Just Peachy Mattes palette. Now this is what the palette looks like. It has all the matte shades. The packaging looks very similar to the Toasted palette. It again comes with a really big mirror, which is great. Then you get your 12 shadows, and all the shades are matte, but this shadow is satin. You get your peachy colors, some browns, you have this beautiful burgundy shade. So again, you can use this as an everyday palette. You can do like a lot of lighter looks, you can do a darker smoky eye looks for your nighttime. Now the formula of these shadows is really good. These are pigmented, you can blend the shadows easily, they are not chalky. So overall it's a good palette, the quality is good, and they smell like peaches, just like their Too Faced other peaches and cream collection. So yeah, overall I think it's a good palette. If you're a fan of matte shades and some warm tone peachy shades, you can give this palette a try. Now next palette is Modern Renaissance palette, and of course it does not need any introduction. So this is by Anastasia Beverly Hills Modern Renaissance palette, and it comes with a mirror like this, and then you get 1 2 3 4 5 6 7, you get 14 eyeshadows. Some of them are matte, some of them are shimmers. Now the shades range from neutrals to burgundy to some warm toned browns, some shimmers, some golden champagne shimmers. So it is a very, very good palette. You can again go create like a really light look with this one, as well as a nighttime look, a very blown out heavy eye look. The formula is really good. It's the shadows are very soft, they blend really beautifully, they are pigmented. So these are, I would say, a little like versatile, as in the other two shadows, the other two palettes that I showed you, the Toasted one and the Just Peachy Mattes one, these are more towards the neutral side. But with this one, you can play a little bit, you can create more diverse looks. So if you are into eye makeup, you can get this one, the Modern Renaissance palette. Now, the last eyeshadow palette is one of my all-time favorites, and this is by Marc Jacobs. Oh my god, the packaging, first of all, it is so cute and it is so sleek, and I have it in 740 Scandalust. Now this is, again, it is slightly similar to Modern Renaissance, I would say. Let's talk about the packaging first. It comes with a mirror like this, and then you get 7 shades. So you are getting lesser number of shadows as compared to the other 3 palettes that I just showed you, but the formula of these shadows is so beautiful. I mean, if I had to pick one out of all the 4 palettes, I would go for this one. But again, this is the one that's like the most expensive. Of course, it's Marc Jacobs. But the formula is so beautiful. It is so soft, so pigmented. I mean, you just need to slightly touch the shadows with your brush and it is going to pick up like a lot. The shimmers are very intense, the mattes are very, very beautiful, very easy to blend, and I absolutely love this palette. It is a little similar to Modern Renaissance, like I said. So let me show you both the palettes. So this is Modern Renaissance and this is Scandalous. So as you can see, there's like a little bit of similarity in the tone of the palette. If you don't want to get this one, you can get the Modern Renaissance palette, but I absolutely love this one. Oh my god, the formula is really, really beautiful, and I also love the packaging. It is so sleek, so you can just slip it in your bag if you're traveling. Okay, so we just have 2 more products and then we are done with this video. So this one is Urban Decay's All Nighter Makeup Fixing Spray. I have it in a smaller bottle. This is a 30 ml bottle, and this is basically a finishing spray. So once you're done with your makeup, just spritz it on your face, and it does kind of lock in your makeup. It makes your makeup stay put for a longer period of time. This is a great makeup fixing spray. If you have problems with your makeup sliding off, if it's in the summers, you know, your makeup doesn't really stick to your face, try this makeup setting spray and I think it is going to make all the difference. It is great. It also comes in a 100 or 120 ml bottle, I'm not really sure, but I have it in a smaller bottle. This is a 30 ml bottle and it is a great makeup fixing spray. Now the last product that I have is easily available everywhere, but the reason I'm advising you to pick it up from Sephora is because you get a lot of fakes of this product, and I'm talking about the good old beauty blender. Now I got this beauty queen beauty blender. It's the same thing, I mean it's the same beauty blender, but yeah, it's in the pink, the bright pink variant, and it's a little dirty because this is what I used on my face today to apply my foundation. So in Sephora you can be guaranteed that you are going to get authentic beauty blenders, because there are a lot of dupes, there are a lot of fakes all over the market. On sometimes you get a fake on Amazon, so it's better to spend all that money on like an original product rather than buying a fake that costs the same amount of money. So again, I don't need to say anything about this. It's a great product. It's so squishy, it just blends your foundation really well. Okay guys, so those were all my recommendations and I hope you liked and enjoyed watching this video, and do comment down below if you have any other favorites from Sephora that of course you don't get in India, that you get outside, any other brand or any other product that you absolutely love. I would love to hear about them. I will see you very soon. Till then, take care and bye.